Om Sam Saraswati Namaha. Namaste. Namaste. On page 44, the 101st name. Om Shuraswara Rupinyayi Swaha. Om Marnatmayayi Swaha. Om Varnanilayayayi Swaha. Om Sudhinyayi Swaha. Om Varnamalinyayi Swaha. Om Kararati Swaha. Om Maharati Swaha. Om Boharati Swaha. Om Sudokchanayi Swaha. Om Kariyi Swaha. Om Kapalinyayi Swaha. Om Krityayi Swaha. Om Korikayi Swaha. Om Singhakaminyayi Swaha. Om Katyayanyayi Swaha. Om Kavadarayayi Swaha. Om Kaladoyami Krityayi Swaha. Om Kaminyayi Swaha. Om Kamabandhyayi Swaha. Om Kamiyai Swaha. Om Vinodinyai Swaha. Om Kanavasume Swaha. Om Kamabandhikai Swaha. Om Kamadure Swaha. Om Kamalavati Swaha. Om Kamai Swaha. Om Karali Swaha. Om Kamandai Swaha. Om Kamandai Swaha. Om Kanyai Swaha. Om Kamalai Swaha. Om Kamalachitai Swaha. Om Kashmira Dipakudoshajayari Swaha. Om Kashmira Dravacharchitai Swaha. Om Kanakai Swaha. Om Kanakavandai Swaha. Om Kanakachalavasinyai Swaha. Om Kanakabai Swaha. Om Kanakastai Swaha. Om Kamakyai Swaha. Om Kanakapradai Swaha. Om Kanapitasitai Swaha. Om Nityai Swaha. Om Kamatamani Vasinyai Swaha. Om Kambupandye Swaha. Om Karalachye Swaha. Om Kishorye Swaha. Om Chalanadinye Swaha. Om Kalai Swaha. Om Kashtai Swaha. Om Nidishai Swaha. Om Kalasai Swaha. Om Kalupinye Swaha. Om Kalakyai Swaha. Om Kalamatrai Swaha. Om Kaladatri Swaha. Om Kalapati Swaha. Om Kalakai Swaha. Om Kalahai Swaha. Om Kalyai Swaha. Om Guru Tulai Swaha. Om Kulanganai Swaha. Om Kirtidai Swaha. Om Kirtihai Swaha. Om Kirti Swaha. Om Kirtisrai Swaha. Om Kirti Bardinyai Swaha. Om Kirtiyai Swaha. Om Kirti Padai Swaha. Om Kritikai Swaha. Om Keshava Priyai Swaha. Om Keshihai Swaha. Om Kelikai Swaha. Om Keshava Nandakarinyi Swaha. Om Kumudabai Swaha. Om Kumari Swaha. Om Karnakai Swaha. Om Kamalekshanai Swaha. Om Kumu Homalangi Sma, Angripa Simre Sma, Angripa Moi Sma, Angusha Patri Sma, Angutta Sakai Sma, Angoveri Sma, Angoshiki Sma, Angkashyapi Sma, Angkatruta Nayai Sma, Angkali Kalmashana Nashimye Sma, Shamayi Isma, Ganurabai
Let's return to page 44, and we'll begin with name number 101. Who is the intrinsic nature of the 16 melodies, or the 16 sounds? And remember, ka ha e I la rim, ha sa ka ha la rim, sa ka la rim, and that's 16. That's the Kahani Vidya of Sri Vidya. And she is the intrinsic nature of Kahani. She is the energy of the Sri Vidya. Who is the manifestation of all colors, castes, and creeds? She's just like Savarni, only she's Varnatmayi. She's the manifestation, the moi of all varnas. So she belongs to everyone. She's with all. She who reposes with all colors, castes, and creeds. She knows no discrimination. All are her children. Of every color, of every caste, of every creed, of every religion, whether they believe it or not. They're all her children. She resides within them. She holds a spear. And remember, the spear indicates one-pointed attentiveness. It's always right on point. She who is the garland of all colors, castes, and creeds. How much fun. She made a mala. She made a garland of all these colors and castes and creeds and philosophies and religions and all these. They just all fit together in a harmony as a garland. She was the dark night of overcoming egotism. And we all know how difficult that is. She comes to us in Kalaratri when we are perplexed by egotism, and she helps us overcome that egotism. They go through the darkness in order to become one with the great radiant light. She who is the great night, and that's the Maharatri, the great night. And the great night has so many applications. It applies to the days of our ignorance, the days of our egotism, the days of our bondage to attachment. It's all part of the darkness, which indicates ignorance. She who is the night of ignorance. Oh. Yes. And that's the ignorance of egotistical attachment as well as the ignorance of not knowing. Sometimes we think we know and we pronounce ourselves really qualified when we are not. And we lay claims to qualities which we don't possess. And this is part of the moha, the ignorance, the delusion which comes from attachment. She who has beautiful eyes. And we can see her. She sees us and we see her. So we get to see her beautiful eyes and she gets to see with her beautiful eyes through our eyes, and the eyes are the gateway to the soul. She who is dark, she is unknowable. How can you know her in the darkness? She who holds a skull, and I pray that it be mine. Because she takes away the personality of the ego, and she holds it in her hand, and she says, you're free from ego now. I have the ego. Look at the skull in my hand. You've given to me your egotism, all of your negativity. She was the doer. And if she's the doer, then I guess I am not the doer. And that's very convenient. She who is beyond darkness. She who moves with a lion. Remember that lion is Dharma. And that lion is the ideal of perfection. She rides the queen of the rides on top of the lion of the ideal of perfection. And that courageous fortitude that lion demonstrates when Dharma comes into contact with the samsara, then the samsara moves aside. He's the king, and she's the queen. Perfect couple. She who is ever pure, and she's just like the pakomach that we talk about in Bengali, the fish who is always at the bottom of the pond, and he hides in the mud, and he's always covered with dirt, and yet he's never dirty, because none of the mud sticks to him. He goes into the samsara, into this world of objects and relationships, and none of the samsara sticks to him. She who supports all talents, and also abilities, and also all attributes, the kala. So she supports all attributes, she wears all attributes, she supports all the talents, every skill, every ability, every attribute which any individual can demonstrate. She is the energy which supports that. She who makes the time of duality, and she who is desired. Because we want to be with you, Mom. Mm-hmm. She who is the most highly praised desire. Because could there be any desire that's more highly praised than being one with God? Mm-hmm. She who is the object of desire. She who is playful. And also, she's playful and she's a joker. And she has a lot of fun. In fact, life is a blast. She has a good time. She's excited about what she's doing. She loves what she's doing, and she's having a good time doing it. And it's a play, it's a game, and she doesn't know. She's not a clock watcher. She doesn't notice the passage of time. She's just having so much fun doing what she's doing. Just like all of you. She who is a desire. She who is the desire that is most beloved. We understand that. She who is the desire that is difficult to attain. Oh boy, it's so much easier to achieve status in the eyes of other men than it is to achieve peace of mind. She is the desire that is difficult to attain, believe me. I certify. But she is attainable. It doesn't say the desire that is impossible to attain. It is difficult. We have to do the sadhana. She who is the spirit of the one who sits on a lotus. And the one who sits on the lotus is Lakshmi, and she is the spirit, the intrinsic nature, the inner urge, the inner being, the inner cause of Lakshmi, who defines the creation, who is the goal of creation, who is the wealth of creation, who is the ultimate wealth of our being. She who is all desires. And that is everything that we desire in life is her. Anything you point to in life and say, I want that, that's another form of the Divine Mother. Because ultimately, the only thing that we desire is God in every form. Everything that we want. So she is all desires. She who is terrifying. And she's terrifying to the ego and to the negativities, because the ego says, I want to be the king. I want to be the controller. And she says, I'm the energy of all. So it's terrifying to the ego. What's she going to do? Why won't she surrender to me? The ego says, I love mother so purely and so much, she will do anything I tell her to. And then she says, I won't do that. I only fulfill the desires of those who don't tell me. Those who are humble and accept my grace. Then their desires are fulfilled. She who is greatly desired, she who leads desire. She shows you where the desire should go, and she pulls that desire into the desired path. The path to find the desire of all desires. She who gives the desire, she who is desire, she who is a lotus. And remember, the lotus stands for peace. She who is offered a lotus, because if we offer our peace to God, then we get the prasad of our worship. She whose breast is smeared with red unguents, and this is usually a red sandal paste. She who is offered red articles, she's a well-read lady. She loves all the red things. She who is gold. And she's gold not only in color like Gauri, but she's also gold in the sense of wealth. And she's in the gold in the sense of the highest wealth that you can contemplate. How can you measure the value of being in the presence of God? She who is the life force of gold, and that means also she is the life force of all that you value, and she is the life force of the currency which is universally accepted, and she is the life force of the true wealth. She who resides upon the golden mountain, and here we have, comes all the way up from Muladhara, and she sits in the Sahasrara, and this is the summit of Mount Kailash. She who is the shine of gold, she who dwells in the ears. And remember, too much and too little were born from Vishnu's ears, from the dirt in his ears. Well, she dwells in the ears and she protects. What's all this stuff we're listening to? Tell that Swami to say nice things, or I'm not going to let them come in the ears. She who is the seer of desire. And she sees all desires and she perceives them and she helps us to discriminate which desires are pure desires which will take us closer to our ultimate goal and which desires are tangential that will waste our time and energy and resources or even take us further away from our goal. She who bestows gold. She who is situated in the pilgrimage place of desire, the Kama Pit. The pilgrimage place of desire. Where do your desires reside? Some people who have lower desires think that the desires reside in the lower chakras. Some people who have a higher desire think the pilgrimage place of desire is in the highest chakras. Jaini drishti, taini srishti. Just as is your desire, so also is your perception of creation. So the place of desire is where you go to make pilgrimage to your desire. If it be a base desire, you make pilgrimage to the lower chakras. If it be a highly evolved desire, you make pilgrimage to the higher chakras. She who is eternal, she resides in the holy place of desire. She who has wrinkles on her neck. And Durga is often described as three lines written on her neck. She who has formidable eyes, because they see everything, and you can't hide from her. she who is youthful, she who has the vibrations of movement, she who has art, and art and all attributes, all skills, all talents. She who is the highest limit. And also, Kashta is the smallest particle of time. Kala Kashta. So it's either the smallest particle of time or the highest of the limits, or beyond limitation. She who is goddess of the moment. Every moment. And she also, means to blink. And ish means the perceiver of the blinking. So she who is the goddess who sees beyond blinking or without blinking. She who is resides in time. She who is the form of time. She who is the knowledge of time. She who is the mother of time. She who is the creator of time. How timely. If she created time, she must be before time. If she gave birth to time, she is the mother of time. She's the form of time. She resides in time. And she's the knowledge of time. She is Kali in every form. She who is the spirit of the arts, and again, the spirit of the talents, the spirit of the attributes. She who is the giver of time. She who is the destroyer of time. She who is with the multitudes. She's here too. She who is with the multitudes who perform actions. Well, we're acting. She who is with the individuals in the community, with every one of us. She who is the giver of fame. She who is the destroyer of fame. She who is fame. She who resides in fame. She who apportions fame. She who knows fame. She who gives the austerity of fame. Because fame has its own austerities. You have to live up to your reputation. She who is the cause of fame. She who is the beloved of Keshava, and that's the name of Krishna. And Ka means the cause, or Brahma, the creation. And A means the situation, the circumstances, or wisdom, that's Vishnu. And Sa means Shiva. And Keshava means Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. He who embodies Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva is Keshava. And that's the name of Krishna. And she is the beloved of Krishna, or Keshava, or Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva. She who takes away the hair. I'm losing mine. I know some people made donations. She took away the hair. She who engages in amorous sports. And she makes us fall in love with her. And the more we fall in love with her, the more we want to demonstrate the sincerity of our love to her. And then we start sitting in an asana and chanting mantras. And pretty soon we learn more mantras and the asana gets longer. And after a while, we're with her a lot. And more and more. She was the cause of bliss to Keshava. So she called Brahma, causes Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva to go into bliss. She was the luster of the moon. And remember, the moon is the moon of devotion. She who is the ever pure one. She was the giver of action. Remember, she writes down in our things to do list every single breath. What she got to do next? She's the giver of action. She who has lotus eyes, and they're not only beautiful, but they perceive peace. She was the cause of the full moon. She was the bliss of the full moon. She who is beyond time. She who is the spirit of the moon. She who supports punishment. Sorry, Mom. She who is angry. She who resides at the summit. She who takes refuge in excellence. She who has a dark throat, just like Shiva. He drank the poison and got a dark throat, and she has a dark throat too. She who has a terrifying body. It's so immense that you can't even perceive the limits of it. It's frightening to perceive infinity. The mind refuses to define infinity. It's terrifying to see the embodiment of infinity. Every time I want to go a little farther, my mind wants to draw a line and said, okay, there's the limit. And I know very well, as soon as I have a limit, that's a new beginning, I can start over again. Going farther and farther and farther. So the mind refuses to define infinity. It's terrifying to the mind. She who is the limbs of time. She who is the illumination of time. She who has a skull in her hand. She who makes desires to be at peace. She who creates skulls as an ornament. She takes all of our negativities and makes a garland of them and wears it. And she's got all the negativities of the universe under her control. She who is the cause of the creation of skulls. She who is the intrinsic nature of the hero of action. Remember, there's a Pashubhav, a Biryabhav, and a Divyabhav. The lower chakras, those who are responding from the lower chakras are Pashu. They are fulfilling their animalistic instincts. They have instinctive behavior, eating, sleeping, and mating. Those who are Virya are heroes. They are heroes of action. And the intrinsic nature of a hero of action is to strive towards perfection. Strive to improve myself. Strive to make ourselves better than we were before. We strive to make ourselves better. And Divya are the highest chakras, the Agni Chakra and the Sahasrara. And those people are divine, like our Srima. She who wears knotted hair. She whose limbs are soft and tender. She who is the ocean of grace, and remember that kripa, that kri means kara, and pa means pa, and kri means do, and pa means get. And what you do is what you get, and that's the grace. And that's the law of karma. Once we understand that and realize and feel it, then we want to do the right things to get the right fruits. She who is the manifestation of grace, just being in her presence, is grace. She who is the spirit of purifying light. She who is situated in a container. And that's every container, and any container only contains her, because she alone is the active principle of this creation. She who is full of wealth. She who comes from within. She who shines like the sun. She who embodies the mother of earthly beings. She who destroys the darkness of the Kali Yuga. Thank goodness. She who knows the lotus. She whose face is like a lotus. She who is offered lotuses. She who shines like a lotus. She who is situated in the middle of a lotus. She who has lotus eyes. And remember, this lotus is peace. And she sits in peace. She manifests in the middle of peace. She shines like peace. And she is offered peace. She knows peace. And her face, when you see it, it just fills you with peace. She who has a being like a tortoise. And the kachup. The tortoise is one who can withdraw all his limbs inside his protective covering and totally shut out the world. Just become nothing but a shell. So her being is like a tortoise. She has total capacity to withdraw completely and move inside. She was the form of desire. She was the letter of ring. And remember, ha means the gross body. Ra means the subtle body. E means the causal body. Anuswar means perfection. The totality of Maya, what can be perceived through the senses, conceived in the mind, known through meditation and intuition, and beyond, ring. The measurement of Maya. She who distributes light like the sun. She who is imperfect. She is imperfect to us as we see her manifestations. We see with our own imperfect eyes, and we ascribe our imperfections to her. She who has the darting eyes of a small bird. She who carries the crippled and exhibits compassion. She who wields the sword of wisdom and cuts down the doubts born of ignorance. Just like Krishna said to Arjuna in chapter 4 of the Bhagavad Gita. She who has the sword of wisdom in her hand. She who flies through space. She who has the intrinsic nature of the sword of wisdom. She who is situated in the sword of wisdom. She who is the form of the sword of wisdom. She who moves with the sword of wisdom. She who exists with the sword of wisdom. She who is creator of the sword of wisdom. She who is the bliss of the sword of wisdom. Ladies and gentlemen, thank God we're well armed. We have the shield of faith and we have the sword of wisdom. And that sword of wisdom cuts down all the doubts that are born from the ignorance of our egotistical attachments. And that's what gives the bliss. She who is the intrinsic nature of the womb of the sword of wisdom. She who is the seer of the sword of wisdom. She who causes the activities of the farmers. As anything you cultivate, you become a farmer. Oh, I love Ram Prasad's song, Mon Krishi Kaj Janonga. Hey, mind, don't you know how to cultivate? What kind of a farmer are you, mind? You're only cultivating all these crazy thoughts about the world. Why don't you cultivate the thoughts about Kali? She who distributes the bliss of the sword of wisdom. She who obeys the sword of wisdom. She who supports the sword of wisdom. She who annihilates the pride in the sword of wisdom. Ladies and gentlemen, this sword of wisdom is really intrinsic to our path. It's a valuable weapon in the tool chest of any warrior who's fighting this battle to win the light. We need that sword of wisdom. She was the Ganges. She who is Godavari. She was Song. She who is Gayatri. And remember, God means wisdom. Three means three. Mahakali, Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati all give their wisdom in song. And that becomes Gayatri. The song of the wisdom of the three. she who resides with the wind, she who is beautiful poetry, she who is with cows. And remember, the root of cow is gall, and gall is light, and all the cows stand for the light, and the light is the wealth, and the light is the wisdom, and the light is the cow, which gives forth nourishment. So the cow is sacred because it's a symbol of light, wisdom, and nourishment. And in that way, it's highly regarded. Especially in a tropical climate, where if you were to kill the cow, you'd only get one meal. But if the cow lives, she will feed you for the rest of your life. Every form of nourishment. She who stands firmly, she who is worshipped with poetry, she who is offered poetry. Hey, do you know what? The rishis are also called kavi, the poets, because they expressed their wisdom and their understanding, their realization with poetry. And that's why we're reading these verses of poetry, and all these names have poetic value. She's offered poetry, she's worshipped with poetry. She who is from the land of music, especially when Srima is singing. She who is the mother of light, she who is proud, she who destroys pride. She's the only one who's entitled to be proud. And not us. She is the door. She should be proud. We are the recipients of her activities. What do we have to be proud about? She who is situated in the womb. She who supports the womb. She who gives the womb. She who takes away the womb. And this womb is the womb of wisdom. It's the womb of realization. It's every womb that gives birth, generates. Remember, G-O-D, the generator, organizer, and destroyer. She generates this wisdom, this understanding, so that we can be compassionate to our fellow creatures in society, in creation. She who is worshipped by the family of Gandharvas, and they sing nicely. Maybe next time. She who is wisdom. She who is rays of light. She who dwells in the kingdom of mountains. She who resides in the mountains. She who exists in the mountains. She who is situated in the midst of the mountains. Remember those mountains, Shaitaputri, that's Himalaya. Himalaya, Shaitaputri is the goddess of inspiration because all the searching souls climb to Kailash. They climb the mountain to the Sahasrara where they can sit in meditation in the union of Shakti with Siva. All the great souls go to the mountains for inspiration. The mountains of peace. The internal mountains and external mountains. She who moves with the Lord of wealth. She who is decorated with a crown. She who sits on the seat. She who shines with a priceless necklace. Especially the one that has our negativities around her neck. She who is the protector of the multitudes. She who is the cause of the multitudes, she who has qualities, she who is the cause of all blissful qualities. You know, every time you feel bliss, it's because you're thinking about her. She whose qualities are worshipped, she whose words are like the song, she who distributes the bliss to the multitudes, she who is the mother of gurus, she who is the support of gurus. She who always has devotion to gurus. And remember, gu karas tanda akaras cha, ru karas teja uchate. The syllable gu, in Bengali, it means watch out where you step. And the syllable ru means illumination. Gu is the darkness, and Ru is the illumination, and Guru is the light in my darkness. She gives us an example. She gives us an inspiration. She gives us a way to change our lives and make them better. She who is the lineage of wisdom, she who pours forth goodness, she who is the partner of the doer of all, and that's Krishna. He does it all.
Boy, did you do it that time.
And she is his partner. She is the Shakti of who does all action. She was the excellence of the doer of all. She who gives birth to the bliss of the doer of all. She who raises the Govardhan mountain. Now, we always saw the picture of Krishna raising the mountain with one finger, but if it weren't for her energy, how could he pick it up? She who supports the lineage of wisdom, she who creates and destroys the Govardhan mountain. Remember Govardhan? Go again is light. It's the mountain where light is disseminated. She who supports the Govardhan mountain, she who gives light. She whose limbs emanate lights. She who gives birth to the soul of Gotam. And Gotam again, he who manifests light. She who shouts. She who is the form of a horse. And remember the form of the horse, we have it in chapter 5 of Chandi. Uchaisrava is the horse of wisdom, who is always running towards the goal of attaining the highest wisdom. Gaura Rupe Maharabe Narayani Namoastute. She comes again in chapter 11. The form of the horse. She who rides a horse. She who shouts with a loud voice. Where'd you think I learned this? She who is dark. She who roars like a cloud. She who is fearless. She who is uninterrupted auspiciousness. That's really cool. The auspiciousness is uninterrupted. She who destroys frightful enemies. She who resides in uninterrupted auspiciousness. She who is the bliss of uninterrupted auspiciousness. She who destroys affliction. Oh. We tried to do 200 names tonight, and we almost made it. Let's see if there are any questions. Yes, please.
Swamiji, you talked about one who does not stick to sansar. Who, when he goes out of the sansar does not stick to him.
Yes, the sansar does not stick to him. He's not bound by attachment.
So how would you characterize such a person? What are the qualities of such a person? And how do you identify such a person?
Oh, you can feel that you're in the presence of such a being, especially when you feel her love, when you see her compassion, when you see her value system, you can understand you're in the presence of a being who is unencumbered by the sansara. There's just love, and there's activity, but the activity is for others, not for that individual, not for her. That's the way she acts. Other questions, please.
Swamiji, on number 117,
yes,
it says she is time of duality.
Yes.
What does time of duality mean?
We perceive duality through time. I'm late. I'm in duality. I've got a lot of stuff to do. I'm in duality. I don't have time to do everything on my calendar today. I'm in duality. She is that time of duality. If you perceive her in the same way as we say, Yade vi sarvabhuteshu bhranti rupena samstita, she exists in confusion. If you see her in the confusion, immediately the confusion dissolves. If you see her in the time of duality, immediately the duality dissolves.
Swamiji, how does this mean? I don't have time to do everything I want to do.
Yes.
At that moment, how do I see her?
I'm seeing that I am here, and the task is there, and the time is here, and I'm in duality.
Yeah.
That's a lot of Maya. If I stop 1 minute and say, Jai Ma, I can see her. In the midst of this time of duality, I can see her. I just forgot about the time of duality. And then I get to be at peace again. And now if I choose to go back to the time of duality, it's no longer I'm late, I'm late, I'm late. It's moreover, well, how do I perform the first task most efficiently? And then what comes next?
Swamiji, a question from Kumari from Vallejo.
Namaste, Kumari Ma.
What is the origin of these thousand names?
These thousand names come from, it's the Annapurna, the Annapurna Sahasranamali, which, this is the Annapurna Stotram. I am not sure. I believe it comes from Padma Purana. But I'm going to check on that for you, and I will give you a clearer definition in the future.
Swamiji, she's also asking, is there a story behind verse 288, which says that she gave birth to the soul of Gautam?
Yes, there is. Of course, Gautam is one of the seven rishis, and he is a mind-born son of a Brahma. And these rishis came forth from the mind of Brahma, and she was the nourishing force, the nourishing energy, which allowed the movement to take place for Brahma to bring forth the soul.
Swamiji, question from Karen from Colorado.
Yes, namaste Karen, namaste Michael.
Why is being playful important to God?
Oh, because all that we are doing is this leela, this drama. All of our activities is just a play, and it's just an act in the cosmic drama. And once we stop taking ourselves so seriously, Karen, it becomes a lot of fun to experience all that we have to experience in this life, because you're going to experience it anyway. Whether you like it or not, you're going to enjoy your karma. So you might as well like it. It's just the attitude of mind. So that's why it's playful to her, and it can become playful to us.